be a great team, they say you must win the Heineken Cup at least twice. And so this afternoon in Cardiff, Leinster pursue victory on the verdict of history. Good evening. There was royalty in the air this week, and this afternoon in Cardiff, Leinster's ambition was to join the aristocracy of European Cup performers. Toulouse, Leicester, Wasps and Munster, who've all won it twice. Could Leinster be next? In the way, Northampton of the Premiership. Joining me in studio, George and Brent, your commentators at Millennium Stadium in Cardiff, Hugh Cahill and Tony Ward.
So after eight grueling rounds over 8 months of European Club Rugby's Premier Tournament, the stage is set for the final of this season's Heineken Cup. Both sides here are searching for their second title. It's 11 years since Northampton last won it, while Leinster's victory in 2009 will still be fresh in the memory. Well, after all the reports this week that Leinster could have been down up to four players through injury, none of those concerns have been ruled out. Brian O'Driscoll's knee has recovered from the knock against Ulster last Friday, and he takes his place alongside Gordon Darcy in the centre. Owen Redden gets the nod ahead of Isaac Boss at scrum half, and Kevin McLaughlin comes back into the pack at blindside flanker. Leo Cullen, as always, will captain the side in the second row. Well, no doubt about the big name absent from the Northampton team sheet, Tom Woods. Hairline fracture in his leg hasn't recovered sufficiently for him to be involved. The Aviva Premiership Player of the Season won't feature on the biggest day for the Saints so far. Callum Clark has been handed the task of taking Wood's place in the back row, and so much has been made of Northampton's scrum, particularly in the front row. Sioane Tongaia, Dylan Hartley and Brian Mujati are as destructive a front three as you will see in the club game. The referee, Mr. Romain Poit from France. The touch judges are Jérôme Garcés and Pascal Gauzère. The TMO, if needed, is Giulio De Santis from Italy. As both teams ready to go, Chris Ashton, the danger man, Ben Foden as well for Northampton. Leinster, well, they've got danger all over the field. And the roof, of course, has been closed for the last couple of days, so that will add to the cauldron atmosphere in Cardiff, as both sets of supporters ready for the first whistle of the game by Romain Poit. And Stephen Moyler, the former rugby league player, will get us underway straight into the hands of Jamie Heaslip. And Leinster with the first opportunity to use the ball. Box kick from Redden. Crucial area of the game today that they don't kick aimlessly to the back three of Foden, who runs straight into Mike Ross and, of course, Diggan and Ashton as well. A step from Moyler, decides to go on the outside, and Downey, the Dubliner, skips through one tackle and gets the offload away to Ashton. Wouldn't be the quickest James Downey, but certainly in terms of physical strength at inside centre, he's been a powerhouse all season, indeed for the last couple of years for Northampton, as Moyler launches one. Slow to chase down Northampton, and the save was called for this one, and he's missed it. Good recovery, though, by the Fijian international, and it's there for Redden once more, to Sexton. Crossfield kick. Ashton just about deals with it. Went backwards, says the referee. Luke Fitzgerald. Trying to find a touch, but the bounce just falling into the arms of Ben Foden. Launches the Gary Owen just over the halfway line. The save, this time calls for it, and again the ball's gone free, and Tongaia hauled to the ground. 23 stone a prop by Jamie Heaslip. Northampton still have Dylan Hartley, the captain, just over the halfway line, tackled by Nathan Hines. There for Dixon. Moyler spreads it out wide again, and Downey tackled by Sexton and Gordon Darcy. But it's a good start by Northampton. Again, they just look to break the first tackle. No offload that time. Tongaia on the outside. Christian Day just over the 22 metre line. Tongaia tackled by Mike Ross. Should be a fascinating battle in the scrums, but this is a very good start by the English side, and they look well up for this game. Hartley wrestled back over the 22, but manages to hang on to the ball, and the referee's whistle goes for the knock-on, and Leinster survive. But that's a great start by Northampton.
Yeah, almost 2 minutes, 20 seconds of non-stop action. You've got to say the Saints, the Northampton Saints, straight into their stride. Impressed by Stephen Myler very in the game. And interesting, when he checked to go with a kick and then gave the pass outside, just there, it managed to catch O'Driscoll off guard. An encouraging start for Downey, managing to get inside him and providing the forward momentum. But certainly advantage to Northampton in the opening 2.5 minutes.
It'll be a Leinster put in. Mike Ross against this man, Tonga Wea. Tongan international, 23 stone of them. Crucial to lock out the first scrum. And Leinster a little bit on the back feet, but he's had the sense to pick and go, but he just couldn't hang on. And Northampton will get the advantage of the set piece put in. You can see what he was trying to do there, Tony. The front row under pressure. He's the one to go, but the hands evading him.
And of course it makes it so much more difficult for the number 8 picking the ball on the retreat, as he was there. Indeed, Heaslip did well to get away with it. He'd be disappointed he didn't hold on to it. But again, as we said, advantage in open play to Northampton the first 2.5 minutes. Psychological advantage for a scrum to Northampton as well.
Ross turned on the inside there. But Dixon happy to let Wilson pick off the base of the scrum. Tackled by McLaughlin. And it's there for Dixon once more. Big physical exchanges early on from both teams, and Callum Clark to Tonga Wea. Darcy struggling to bring him down. The ball's gone loose, and Nathan Hines is the man who's come free with it. Good Leinster defence, and you can hear the crowd absolutely roaring for the first 5 minutes of continuous play almost. Sexton taken back inside, can't go straight into touch. It's a huge kick by Jonathan Sexton. Has it gone too far? Well, it has gone dead. And we'll have to go all the way back, Tony. Unlucky for Jonathan Sexton there. He got a tremendous strike on him.
I agree. I feel for him there. He knows himself. He actually struck that really sweetly. It went an awful lot further than he expected it to go. And unfortunately, what it means is it's a scrum back to Northampton on the 22. A wonderful attacking position. Touch.
Pause. Again. Good hit from Leinster that time. But Northampton try and get a shove. They don't make too much ground. It's gone up in the front rows. An advantage to the English side. And they're going to try and use it. Why not? Diggin. Tackled by Heaslip. Roman Poit playing the penalty advantage to Northampton. Little gap there for Denny. The offload. Dowson. He's over the line. Did he get the touchdown? He did. Referee right on the spot. And the first try has gone to Northampton. Well, the hands off the back of the scrum. They knew the penalty advantage was coming. Dixon who set it up. A lovely run back inside to Clark, and Dowson buried his way over. In the corner, conversion to come. This is not the start that Leinster would have wanted, but Jim Mallander absolutely delighted with his team and the intensity they showed. Diggin, there's the quick feed. He's only 5'8", Paul Diggin. But a low centre of gravity. Clark to Dowson, the two back row forwards. What a try.
And of course, when the front row goes up like that, there's no power coming through at all, and naturally you're going to be going back at a rate of knots. After that, the Leinster defence had difficulty getting reorganised. And really, it was almost a tackle by Owen Redden that prevented them getting over, but too little too late.
Stephen Myler has a reputation, if he misses his first kick, to be struggling for the rest of the match, but this is an important one. Struck it well. Looks pretty good from here. Well, what a kick. Flags go up. 5 points become 7. Northampton are off to a cracker.
You know, whatever does it for you in that case, Myler, this habit of looking up the posts and down, as you see the eyes focused on the ball, but it works for him. And that was some strike from the almost on the left-hand touchline. The perfect start for Northampton.
There's the feed from Dixon. Better from Leinster this time, making life difficult. Wilson picks off the back, and he breaks through the gap as well. Roger Wilson there, how much pace has he got? Not enough to get past Jamie Heaslip. And the ball's gone forward as well. Referee playing advantage to Leinster. Sean O'Brien makes another few metres. Clark getting his hands on it, but he's right in front of the referee, and he's off his feet. And Tony Ward, an opportunity perhaps for Jonathan Sexton to get Leinster off the mark here.
And ironically, coming at the back of the superb breakout by Roger Wilson. Wilson did very well to get away here. He picks the ball and he slices the Leinster. Now it suits him. It wheels around just perfectly, left shoulders. But doesn't he do well to get away here from Sean O'Brien? Step inside Jamie Heaslip. He'd be disappointed with that. But then, much like Heaslip with a break earlier on, he spilt the ball, turned it over. penalty opportunity for Sexton.
Struck it well. Definitely has the distance. Definitely has the direction, and Leinster fans have something to celebrate. It's 3 points from Jonathan Sexton. How important is he going to be this afternoon, Tony?
You know, given the enormity of the occasion, given the pressure, that's the type of kick he would have wanted to start it off. So his confidence should be up from the get-go.
Touch. Touch. Pause. Engage.
There's the feed from Dixon. Solid Northampton scrum. In fairness, that's a hell of a lot better from the English side, and they get the penalty as well. Dixon thought about the quick one. This is probably just outside Moyler's range. So, if I was a guessing man, I'd say he'd go up the line and try for the line-out, but a really solid scrum by Northampton there.
Again, I mean, they had been edging a little bit sideways, but that, I think that's well within his range here, I have to say, just outside the 10-metre line. I know he favours it closer in, but I think he's well capable, given the fact that the roof is on.
Yeah, he's pointed for the sticks, in fact, and he's going to have a shot at goal. Not an easy kick. He's one from one so far. And this to stretch the lead back to 7 points.
It's almost evil the way the eyes look at the posts and then.
Connected really well, but has he pushed it out? It looks like it's just crept on the inside. The flags go up. That's a really, really good kick from Stephen Moyler. 2 from 2. We wondered, Tony, about his form, place kicking wise, coming into this game. So far, he's been perfect. Richard Strauss. Again, they go to the back. Leo Cullen taps it down for Sean O'Brien. Not the cleanest, but Leinster have, and Shane Horgan in off his wing, manages to make a few metres, and he's got the support from Sean O'Brien. Back inside, Leinster over the 22, Brian O'Driscoll going for the corner, just tackled, and it went forward once again. The opportunity, Tony, for the tackling from Northampton, Ben Foden with a try-saving tackle.
Without a doubt, 5 points if not seven, but this is what Leinster can do. They can cut you open from anywhere. Inside pass to Horgan, his strength gets him in, but look at the blue shirts in support. Lovely hands, and you think O'Driscoll's going to go all the way, but what a try-saving tackle by Foden, for sure.
Got the man, got the ball. Decent take from Clark. Box kick from Dixon. He's put too much on that one, and Shane Horgan has loads of time to find his fullback. Mathewa, does he need a bit of help? Yes, he does. Good tackle again from Courtney Laws. So mobile for a second row, 6'7". Almost like a basketball build, but Kevin McLaughlin escapes the first tackle. Keane Healy looks like he was held in the outside there, Tony, and that's the penalty, and we could see a card here. That was deliberate, and it's Mojati who's gone.
Could and should and did, without doubt. Healy was in support of McLaughlin. McLaughlin's quick feet taking him through the gap. And Leinster causing Northampton a lot of difficulty in that area with the number of players they're managing to get involved. Well, that's a good call by the referee. How often do we see a warning given? That is the only decision should be made. Professional foul, bin. 10 minutes.
10 minutes is going to bring him up to within three of the halftime whistle. You can see the take from McLaughlin skips around the first. Keane Healy was in support. Mojati with the arm around him, cynical as they like. Here's a better angle of it, and referee well placed.
Pause, engage.
Certainly Mojati will be a loss in the scrum, but Northampton again get the shove on, and it's another really, really good scrum by the English side. Look at that, they've made 10 metres and the penalty. Tony Ward, that's simply destruction of a Leinster front row that is dealt with Toulouse, Leicester, you name it, Clermont Auvergne, but they're not dealing with Northampton today.
And that could be a seminal moment in the game for sure.
Here we see it again. Mercer, Tongawea. The initial shot by Leinster was good, but look at the second drive, as you mentioned, Tony. Phenomenal to watch. Dowson there didn't stay behind. Maybe that was a case and argue there. Richard Strauss and Dylan Hartley. Shortage of physicality from both teams, I'll use that word, but another attacking threat here from Northampton. Christian Day goes up in the red scrum half. It's a good ball off the top, and again it's down. He is asked to carry, tackled by Heaslip. Dixon, Courtney Laws, Keane Healy puts them down, but Northampton still have, and they're making a couple of metres every time. Ben Foden. Leinster's defence being tested here once again. Christian Day started the move from the line-out, made his way all the way across, and Northampton still have. Switch back inside to Roger Wilson, tackled by O'Driscoll. Dixon again, numbers on the right here now. Northampton want to move this ball. Courtney Laws tackled by Fitzgerald, but it was a forward pass, and Leinster will get the scrum and a chance to clear. But Northampton look very, very dangerous.
Very dangerous, and it's almost as if numbers on jerseys don't matter. The number of times you've mentioned Day and Law's names in commentary, Day taking the quick ball off the top, Law and Day involved then in the follow-up play, and that was a chance. I mean, it was a forward pass, and to be fair to the referee, he's been consistent in that regard. He's in line and he does pick it up. We may just see it here again, but there Courtney Laws carrying the ball, Christian Day coming around, and then everybody involved, backs and forwards, making forward momentum all the time. That time it's Ben Foden, and again second row Christian Day involved, and this was a chance. There's the forward pass, and again Christian Laws on the end of it.
Well, Leinster will have the opportunity through the scrum to get this one clear, but it's an area they've struggled, as we've mentioned. And Northampton will be eager to try and set possession, particularly for Redmond at the back. Got up on the front row, and it's one against the head. Northampton half, Leinster having to drift across. They weren't expecting that. And it's John Clark. Good strength from the outside centre. But the Leinster scrum in all sorts of trouble at the moment. Northampton half. Downey inside the 22. Options left and right. Foden into active scrum half. And they work the blind side. Roger Wilson tackled by Liam Cullen. Dixon this time. Little switch from Myler back inside to Dowson. Try score in the opening few minutes for Northampton, and they still have. Myler, little shot from Myler, almost through, 5 metres short. Great tackle by Owen Redden, who's now put himself in an offside position. The referee says play on the right-hand side. Foden from the corner, and Ben Foden's in. Northampton's got their second try. They're tearing Leinster apart. And what a time. Before the break, down to 14 men to move 15 points to 3 ahead, Tony Ward.
Well, there's one team playing all the rugby at the moment, and it's sure not the one in blue. It'll be an exaggeration to say Leinster are being bullied, but certainly physically Northampton are putting it up to them at the moment. And bear in mind that was a scrum against the head, and after that Stephen Myler breaking clean through, and Ben Foden in for the try. And you've got to say again, it is no more than they deserve given the effort that's going in and the pressure being exerted everywhere.
Scrum against the head, started the move off. John Clark breaking the tackle, setting momentum up. Myler again with the gap, almost got over himself. A wonderful tackle by Redden. But this is where Northampton took advantage. They spotted the speedsters out wide. Ben Foden, one-on-one against O'Driscoll. Well, Brian O'Driscoll missing the tackle. Foden, the quick feet, the younger feet. And maybe just more hungry to get for that line.
You know, and you've got to say, in fairness, it's uncharacteristic of O'Driscoll, but you've got to wonder, Hugh, you've got to wonder how relevant is that injury. That is, the sharpness is just missing, managing to make those extra couple of feet to make the tackle. It's just not there at the moment.
All this with Mujati in the bin. And 15 points could become 17 if Myler continues his 100% record. Very similar to Dowson's try, same position for the kick. And in his form, he wouldn't bet against him. Myler, what a strike. He knows straight away, down for the tee. Doesn't even want to see it go over. What a kick by Myler. Well, Northampton fans, every reason to celebrate in the Millennium Stadium, because they are well in control of this match. And they lead by 17 points to 3.
That is a two-goal advantage. That's two converted tries Leinster need to get level. And imagine the boost when Northampton returned to 15 players. Leinster at the moment have a serious hill to climb.
33 minutes gone, and Mathewa up against Dowson. Only one winner there. 6 foot 5 of flanker. Back to Myler. He was under pressure.
One, stay there.
Well, he did well to get it away, and Shane Horgan on the outside is Jonathan Sexton. This is where the experience of Leinster players like Horgan, like O'Driscoll, Leo Cullen come in handy. But Ben Foden, from try score, takes a beautiful ball out of the air. Northampton look very comfortable. Luke Fitzgerald trying to get something going. Myler makes the tackle. And Redden, Sexton, chip over the top. He was hit a little bit late there. The crowd are on their feet, appealing for the referee's decision, but Rowan Watt wants none of it, and Foden skips around Eason Athewa. Answer for player down. I think it's Jonathan Sexton. Darcy. Still going, Gordon Darcy. Eventually tackled by Dylan Hartley. Cian Healy. And there is the penalty. And we might have a word to one of the Northampton players for the late tackle on Jonathan Sexton there. And this is the late hit on Jonathan Sexton. It was late. I mean, that was cynical, Tony, you'd have to say. Shoulder into the face there. Leinster needs something. Jonathan Sexton's only had one opportunity to strike for goal. This is number two. It's not easy. Well, he took his time over that one. Flags go up at the back for Leinster fans. The touch judges' flags also go up, and 17 points to 6 with 5 minutes left to play in this first half.
Touch. Pause. Engage.
Solid scrum once more from the English team. It's gone down. Referee happy to let Roger Wilson feed it out to his back line. We've seen what they can do from these kind of situations already. Tristan Turn, John Clark, he beats one. The tackle's not going in from Leinster first time, and it's allowing Northampton to get the momentum. Courtney Laws, tackled by his opposite number, Leo Cullen, who must roll away. There for Dixon again. Myler, numbers out wide now. Foden looks for the corner. Ashton, back inside. Can't get past Brian O'Driscoll. Once again, Leinster under real pressure. Dixon trying to dig it out to Hartley. Makes another metre. Pick and go again, this time Clark just back on the field, the 21-year-old, good strength from him. And Dixon wants it, goes to blindside again, Ashton almost there! Chris Ashton for the line, but he was just held short. Strength from the winger. Leinster hanging on for dear life here, another try would be disastrous, you'd feel. Pick and go once more from Northampton, are they over? Ball's down, but referee has a good look, he can't see. He's going to go upstairs, I think, to the television match official.
That means Hugh, he thinks it is a try. That's his feeling. So unless he's told there's any reason he cannot award it, we could well have another try here.
Well, can we see from these angles? This is what the TMO can see. There's the ball on this Dylan Hartley's right hand. That looks to be a try, Tony.
That looks a try to me as well. I think Leinster are in grave trouble. This looks a try. And Hugh, again, you've got to say, the mistakes Leinster are making, the way the defence has been taking apart, that looks a score to me.
There's the ball. It's on the ground. It was Dylan Hartley's arm. That's
over the line, carried over by Northampton. Yes,
try.
It's a try.
Try number three for Northampton. And 16-point gap. I mean, it's not over. It certainly is a huge uphill struggle.
It's not even half-time, and you've got to say, this Heineken Cup Final 2011 is now Northampton's to lose. They are in control. Here again, getting through so easy, and that is so unlike the Leinster we've known all season. Gaps everywhere.
Ben Foden spotting the space out wide. Ashton almost got over a couple of times. Stopped by O'Driscoll there. But it's just the control and the patience by Northampton to spot where the weakness is. And that was a really well taken try. Myler, he's been perfect so far. Oh, inches in that one. We've gone the 40 minutes. And the referee blows his half-time whistle. It's been a half to forget for Leinster. I'm sure they'll want the comfort of the dressing room, and perhaps Joe Schmidt and John O'Gibbs can find some words to try and pick their team up. But at the moment, there's only one team heading for the Heineken Cup title. That's Northampton. They lead by 22 points to 6 at half-time. We'll be back with the second half after this break.
prices start from only €99 for juniors, €239 for adults, and family tickets from €649. Each ticket covers all 17 home matches. Offer only available until June 1st. For more info or to buy tickets now, check out leinsterrugby.ie/season tickets.
Try the delicious new Brazier from KFC, our first ever griddled chicken. It's the sizzle.
Welcome back for the second half of the Heineken Cup final. Leinster trailing by 22 points to 6 in a match that has seen Northampton play above and beyond anything certainly I've seen all season, and Leinster hardly recognisable from the side that beat Toulouse, Leicester, Clermont-Auvergne, Racing Metro and Saracens on their way to the last two. Tony Ward is beside me. Tony, what can Leinster do to try and get back into this game?
Well, that helps for starters. It looks as if they've just turned it over, but certainly apart from the obvious posting at least two early tries, they need to match Northampton physically up front. They're being bullied out of it in the opening 40 minutes, and then put the structures in place that we've seen all season and put the width on the ball and attack them where we know they can.
Redden to Darcy. Sexton standing in centre. Outside is O'Driscoll. An early try here would be just the tonic and just the reply that I'm sure Joe Schmidt and his coaching staff would want to see. Nathan Hines, guilty of a few errors handling-wise, but this time he hangs on. And maybe the second half we'll see Leinster turn the leaf and play the way they have been playing all season and get back into this game. Keane Healy settles ball at the back as the Leinster fans on their feet trying to encourage their team. One substitution is Shane Jennings on for Kevin McLaughlin. Maybe he'll provide a bit of pace in the back row and try and secure possession. But again, it's Northampton's defence solid, Leinster isolated, and almost don't seem to know exactly what the plan is. Sean O'Brien, haven't seen too many bouldering runs from him. Here he is, Jennings, substitute on, fresh legs in the back row. Redden to O'Brien. Northampton up very quickly. This time they go wide. Sexton, Horgan, little loop from Sexton again. Nice hands, Nasewa. Up to the goal himself. He had support on the outside. Ball there for Redden and Clark contesting. But Leinster, you would feel, inside the 22, need a return on the scoreboard here. Better start by the Irish side. Northampton having to defend. Mujati, they smell the ball. Have they managed to turn this one over? It's there. And Dixon has. And really, that is just careless from Leinster. Lack of concentration, lack of physicality to secure possession. And Tony, they're not going to win this game unless they can secure a ball.
Hugh, it's just not good enough.
Leinster have the line out. It's Rickard Strauss to throw. He's gone to the back almost every occasion. Sean O'Brien the target. Clean ball for Redden. And they get something going again. Sexton tries to slip inside, but stopped in his tracks. Sean O'Brien again the target, and again he makes a couple of metres. O'Driscoll pick and go by the centre, looks for support inside, he finds his man Heaslip, 5 metres short. Jamie Heaslip started by O'Driscoll, and Leinster are there again. Can they get something on the board? Nathewa calling for it on the left, and he gets it, the full back. It'll show by him, tries to skip through. Easton Nathewa 2 metres short. Darcy in to help. Leinster almost over. O'Driscoll. Millennium Stadium full of shouts from the Leinster fans. They want to see something on the board. No more mistakes, and they go wide. Surely this time, Sexton, he's in. Jonathan Sexton over for Leinster. That's the response. Look at the determination of Sexton. And Tony, that's exactly what those fans have wanted to see.
And the team, we cannot emphasise enough how important that try is. And it took O'Driscoll to do it. Again, I emphasise, because they're panning out so much, O'Driscoll spots there's nobody at home. That's where the gaps are, around the ruck, at the breakdown, because Northampton are spreading from touchline to touchline. And in the end, they managed to put this one away. It is a vital score. It'll give them confidence. Sexton in the end on a mismatch. And in he goes. And you've got to say, given the way they've started that this half, apart from the one turnover, it's deserved.
This would be a massive boost to add to his 5 points from the try and the 6 points from two previous penalties. That's what faces him. pushed a little bit to the left as he brought in an offie. It's off the post and it's gone over. Well, you take them any way they come. Jonathan Sexton started on the left. It just came back enough. Help from the post. 11 becomes 13, and all of a sudden, the game has taken a significantly different tone. Jamie Heaslip, tackled by Brian Mujati. And Redden, again. Came off the foot of a Northampton player, but it's gone as far as Sean O'Brien, who again makes the meter in contact and sets the ball up. Sexton, it just got almost through. Pick and go by Nathan Hines to Redden. Looks for support from Cullen. Darcy slips one tackle. It's good stuff by the centre. Plenty of numbers out wide for Leinster. If Redden can get the pass away, Tongawea in danger of straying offside there. But O'Driscoll has thought about the pass to Healy. Probably the wise decision just to set it up. Here they come again. Heaslip looks for support from Shane Horgan. He's 5 metres out. Shane Horgan eventually brought down. Much better by Leinster. And they're looking for try number two inside the 10 minutes that we talked about. Can they get over? Redden. Options blind. Nathan Hines missed out. Sean O'Brien. 2 metres short now. The need to retain possession. Redden looks for runners outside. Heaslip again. Patient stuff by the Irish team. Strauss. Numbers out wide. Sexton. Lethewa. There's an overlap if they can use the ball. O'Driscoll comes back in. Lost his footing at the crucial stage. Fitzgerald fancies his chances. Luke Fitzgerald to lay the pass. Darcy, he's over. Is he down? Well, he thinks he is. We're going to go upstairs. Tony Ward. It's certainly much better from Leinster. Was that a try?
But certainly, judging by Darcy's initial reaction, it seemed as if he got it. I must say, I felt if O'Driscoll had let the ball go originally, it might have been him.
He's just getting it on. Cullen's asked him to go upstairs. Good to see it again.
Make sure your tackle is on the limit, okay? Allowed, the limit allowed.
What a chance that was for Leinster. Okay.
But the referee must have been very well, oh, he is going upstairs.
He is going upstairs. Leo Cullen asked him to make sure.
Is it a try, yes or no?
A try, yes or no, that's the question. I mean, Darcy thought he was over. It then looked like the referee spotted a knock-on. Fitzgerald delayed it. He came back and said he had 3 players, 4 to beat. He was over. Did he get it down? Blair. No. You can't see from that angle.
No. TMO cannot award the try because he cannot see it being touched down there. He's certainly over the line. Maybe from this angle here.
Using the upper body strength. It was digging. It was underneath them. Can't see from there. Well, if it's inconclusive, he can't award it.
No try, Scrum Blue.
Scrum Blue. Leinster's still there, but the right decision, Tony. Five metres out. This is where the Saints scrum will be worth their weight in gold. If they can disrupt Leinster ball here, perhaps even win a penalty. Watch the shove. That's much better from Leinster. Lock tight. Darcy, once again, been asked to carry up now. Quick ball needed. Redden digs it out. Cullen's outside him. Hits the ground straight away. Tackled by Downey. But Leinster won quick possession. They've got the pace in the back line. Sexton switch with O'Driscoll. 5 metres out. The Irish captain and Leinster centre setting ball up for a scrum half. Again they go. Heaslip tackled by John Clark. Ripped from Cian Healy. Redden wants to go blind. Sean O'Brien needs help. He's got 5 Northampton players in front of him. And the scrum cap ripped from his head in the collision. Mike Ross, it's all about sucking in numbers here. And Northampton, I'm sure, wary not to give away a penalty. Little loop again. We've seen it work for Leinster before. Sexton in for one. Is he in for two? He is! He's over, Jonathan Sexton. Second try for the fly half. That was all about strength, it was all about timing, the vision to spot the gap, Tony. Leinster are back in this game.
an amazing transformation, and suddenly it is Leinster taking the game to Northampton. They're no longer accepting the bullying that went on in the first half. It's the physicality, where it matters most, is coming from Leinster, and they've still got the class behind to create the gaps, and that time it's Sexton who does it, and it took determination to you, as you rightly said, at the second attempt he got in. And again, we would have to say, it is no more than this second half so far deserves from Leinster.
It's a different side that are playing in blue jerseys in the second half. Sexton, round one, round two, and past three. Callum Clark bowed his head, he couldn't believe he missed him, but Sexton's determination, he's got to keep a cool head and slot this to make it a 2 points and a one score game. Should be a formality. It is 22 points to 20. And all of a sudden, the game has taken a completely different complexion. Sexton, we've seen that loop so many times. Northampton, you suspect, were expecting the pass. Sexton put his head down. What a try.
And dare we suggest, we are witnessing one of the great Heineken Cup finals. Leinster right back in it.
Scrum does not give an inch. Move called, and Leinster get the better of Northampton for the first time in a set piece, and they've won the penalty. Tony, explain to me, is it a mindset? Is it determination? How can they overturn a situation where in the first 40 minutes they were completely bullied, as you said?
Well, it's a combination. I mean, you made the simple point that clearly Joe Schmidt and John O'Gibbs, I'm sure everybody was involved in a few harsh words, but we made the point, quite flippantly perhaps, going in at half-time, that this was Northampton's to lose. And it looks as if they've come out the second half thinking, in a sense, job three quarters done. And it's not. It is a different... And they would have known Leinster would have to give it everything. But to start the way they have started, in what were 15 minutes into the second half, and the game has turned around completely.
This... to put Leinster ahead for the first time in this final. Hasn't missed one yet, and he won't miss from there. Jonathan Sexton, 3 points for Leinster. They're ahead by one, and Northampton at the moment look completely shell-shocked. He can go. Wilson. Cian Healy trying to wrestle it free. Myler. Carry on from him. Matthew was called for this one. He's got to take it. What a take. What a catch by Easton Matthew. Sets ball up for Leinster. Cian Healy shrugs past one. Takes two to haul him down, and they can't. Over the 10-meter line. Brilliant run by the 23-year-old. Redden. Horgan. Sean O'Brien comes back in. Bounces off Dixon, bounces off Myler. Unbelievable strength by the Tullow man. And he's almost at the 22, and Leinster possession once again. Red momentum is key, and it's all with Leinster. O'Driscoll out to Darcy. Back inside to Nathewa. Tries to slip the tackle of Dowson. But Northampton having to defend once again. Redden comes blind. Switch with O'Driscoll to Sexton. 17 points already, looking for another one. O'Driscoll just stopped short, and the advantage with Leinster. Can they get another one? Nathewa, the pass was on. Nathan Hines, they have the penalty, but that was a six-man overlap, Tony Ward. Deliberate knockdown, we could see a card.
I think so, absolutely. Right call again by the referee. Leinster are playing like supermen. Cian Healy, Sean O'Brien, Brian O'Driscoll, Gordon Darcy, Johnny Sexton, you name it. And they should have had another 5 or 7 points there. They'll take the three. They are on fire.
With 20 minutes left to play. Struck it well. The crowd like it, the touch judges like it, and he likes it. 20 points for Jonathan Sexton. Leinster up to 26. It all started from that take by Easton Athewa, where in the first half he missed three of those. At the moment, it's Leinster in control in every part of the game, including at the scrum. Jamie Heaslip straight into Moyler, sets ball up for Redden. Sean O'Brien ploughs over the first, the pass to Strauss, he's got the legs, and the pass to Cullen just hangs on. Brilliant take by Leo Cullen, the Wicklow man. O'Driscoll, Darcy, back to Rickard Strauss. Once again, Leinster piling into the 22, and they've got numbers both sides. Sexton calling for it. Skip ball out to Horgan. Pass back inside to Sexton almost. Did it go forward? It went backwards, says the referee. Horgan picks and goes. Strength by the Meath man. And he's 2 metres short. Leinster still have. Darcy to secure. Nathan Hines. Sean O'Brien. 15, 15. Northampton having to defend for their lives. Another try here would be disaster for them. 15 minutes to play. Sean O'Brien, 1 metre short. Pick and go again from Leinster. They're over, but are they down? They are! Another try. Roman Poit right on the spot. And you feel that Leinster's runaway train momentum, nothing are going to stop them.
What can you say? That to seal it. And Nathan Hines did so well to get it down. And full credit to the referee. He was in position. He didn't have to go upstairs. That is a beaten side. What a remarkable comeback by Leinster. It's wave after wave of intensive attacking right across, every player involved.
Nathan Hines leaving Leinster at the end of this season. And the man from Wagga Wagga has just added another try to an already impressive scoreline in the second half. Rickard Strauss, Sean O'Brien, all the big men involved, O'Brien in particular. It's just so hard to stop. Strauss to Cullen, the hands from Leo Cullen for a second row forward.
Look at the numbers you're using. 2, 4, 7, 8, 5. Unbelievable. The ball handling skills. And that's what Joe Schmidt has brought to Leinster this season. And this half, it is really coming to fruition. Magnificent.
Well, why start missing now? Flawless. Absolutely flawless.
That makes this half 27-0. Unbelievable.
Touch. Ball. And game.
Dixon defeat. Look at that Leinster scrum. Look at that Leinster scrum. Geraghty. Numbers out wide. They've got to try something. Foden is in for one already. Trying to use his pace, and he's used it very well. Support on the outside from Ashton. We know he has pace. Comes back inside, Chris Ashton. At the 22 and tackled by Nathewa. Well, if Northampton were to score here, it's certainly not over. But Leinster look like they've turned it over once again. They got back, and they got back in numbers. Sexton to clear inside the 22, which means he can go straight out. And straight out he has gone. And that's another example of Leinster at their absolute best. The face by Foden, Ashton in support, and look at Nathewa to get back.
Yeah, it's the only way though you feel, and brilliant play again by Foden in attack, but Foden and Ashton is the only way they're going to score. And Nathewa, as you rightly said, Hugh, what a recovery tackle, getting back man and ball, and that allowed Leinster get back in numbers to force the turnover. But that's brilliant attacking play by Foden, finding Ashton on the outside, he checks in, and somewhere on the way, Nathewa, man, there he is, manages to get back.
Watch the hit.
Man and ball, what a hit.
Ashton picking himself up, he's limping. He's had a physical few days or so. Running with two laggy, we won't mention that one. We talked about all week, but certainly he looks in trouble, Chris Ashton. As Geraghty tries to get something going to Ansbro, but the pass not ideal. Dowson back on the field, Foden back inside, digging. Tackled by Horgan. Inside the 22, Northampton desperate for something. And we know that they're capable. Three tries in the first half, nothing in the second so far. Geraghty again. Leinster now defending with purpose, and they're shutting off those angles, and they're closing down the space. And the pressure that Northampton applied in the first half, Leinster are doing to them in the second. And that's the penalty. And once again, it's that word, Tony, pressure.
Pressure, the reverse of the first half. And they're playing the ball on the ground. Referee absolutely on the spot, but the pressure coming from Leinster at the breakdown. To be fair to Northampton, since Shane Geraghty has come on, they're threatening, they're pushing the ball wide, and they are asking questions, but Leinster still coming up with all the relevant answers.
Again, Leinster lockout. Look at Van der Merwe, look at the pressure from the South African. Northampton do get a shove, controlled at the back. And Wilson earns the penalty. Good stuff. Quick tap and go. They need a try. Northampton. Geraghty takes the pass from the scrum half. Clark back inside. Sexton tackles. Fergus McFadden in there too. Is there any way through for Northampton? Over the halfway line they go. Tackles going in. Substitute hooker Brett Sharman from the South African to Geraghty. Joe Ansbro. It's Clark again. Tackled by McFadden and Sexton. No way through the Leinster wall. 5.5 minutes left to play. Roger Wilson. Ball's gone loose. Van der Merwe after it. Couldn't get his foot or hand on it, but Northampton still have. Crucially for Leinster, they've made very little ground. Geraghty trying to find a gap. Finds Ashton. McFadden passed to nobody. It went forward. Referee playing advantage to Leinster. And well, so they went backwards. He originally was playing advantage, but the substitute Sharman. Tackled by Jamie Heaslip. Try here would still give the Saints a glimmer of hope. Ansbro, the pass to no one, that definitely went forward, and the advantage this time definitely coming to Leinster. Isaac Boss to Nathewa, rubber kick around the edge, advantage is over, says the referee, touch found, and with 4.5 minutes left to go, Tony, you'd imagine it's one step too far from the time.
No, that should be it now, but you know, again, I make the point, Geraghty has certainly added something since it came on, in terms of chasing the game for Northampton. But even this, a very clever kick by Nasewa. Look at the ground game there with his left foot down the touchline. And he knew exactly what he was doing.
Well, what a performance from Jonathan Sexton. Huge hug from Jason Harris-Wright. The two youngsters in the team. Sexton, well, I suppose not a youngster anymore. Owen O'Malley on the bench as well, congratulating what has to be a man of the match performance by Jonathan Sexton. Can they finish with another score? He's the back inside to Sean O'Brien. 15 seconds until Leinster get their hands on this Heineken Cup for the second time after 2009. Beaten semi-finalists last season. They've done it the hard way this year in arguably the toughest group ever in the Heineken Cup. Their path in the knockout stages has not been easy. They've beaten Leicester, they've beaten Toulouse, and they will have beaten Northampton. Once the whistle goes, one last play, Isaac Boss. Stan Wright. And the ball goes dead. Leinster will be victorious. Madigan kicks it out. The whistle goes and Leinster have done it. The 15th to win two Heineken Cup titles. Tony Ward, how they have deserved it.
You know, and I've got to again repeat the statistics. 27 unanswered points in the second half. Amazing. What a turnaround. I mean, people talk of games of two halves. That was the original and one of the greatest Heineken Cup finals ever. It's just a privilege to be able to witness it. What a wonderful performance by Leinster. A good team, as I said, has become great.
Champions for 2011. What a performance in Cardiff. Where Munster won their first title in 2006, Leinster have added their second, and it's fully deserved, and this will go down as one of the great days in Leinster history.
You know, we struggled first half to get any type of platform, and you know, it's a tough game when you can't get that. Every time they got a scrum, they seem to just blow us back, and we were shell-shocked a bit, and we needed half-time to regroup.
We had a chat about it at half-time, and obviously we weren't happy the way we were playing, throwing 50-50 passes, and you know, we just weren't sticking to our game plan, so we just said hold the ball in the second half and let's run at them. And you know, just try to outwork them, and that's what we did, you know, for the 40 minutes.
We came here, you know, we've had a brilliant run in this European Cup. We gave it our best shot, you know, we gave it a tremendous first half, and I think, you know, Leinster quality side showed in there.
Well, we took a couple of minutes to recover from probably not the physical effort, but the mental anguish that was the first half for us, and then we just sort of got together, said, righto lads, if we hold on to the ball and construct some phases and start to get the tempo of the game and our rhythm going. There are opportunities out there. We've broken their line a few times. All we need to do is hold on to the ball beyond those line breaks and then construct a little bit more play, and they'll either make an error or we'll get over the line.
Well. What an absolutely fantastic result of the last six Heineken Cups. Four have been won by Irish teams. Leinster now join the greats with two wins, and that result also means that Connacht are in the Heineken Cup next year. Where do we begin to start working out what happened, Brent? Well, first of all, we should congratulate Leinster on a magnificent performance.
Absolutely, and I think if you take the whole season's perspective, I mean, look at the groups. I mean, you know, they've beaten three of the top four present French sides, Racing, you know, Clermont. You've got two of the top English sides, which were in their group, Saracens and then Leicester, so, and Toulouse along the way. So their route has been incredible. I mean, it was the strangest game, I'd have to say, today. It's all we were saying, was it a great game? It's a great result. But the game was so one-sided in the first half, and the second side was one-sided in the second. So I don't know whether it mashed together as a particularly great... It was a great performance, but I don't know whether it was a great match to watch.
It'd be one of the great mysteries of Irish rugby, what went on in the dressing room. Apparently Johnny Sexton stood up and made a speech.
Well... I don't normally go with the dressing room idea, you know, that somehow this coach comes in, whoever he might be, and in the dressing room he changes it. I think the difference between these two sides at halftime was Leinster had a lot of leaders. Johnny Sexton, very much so. But you have Sexton, you have O'Driscoll, you have Cullen, you have leaders. Northampton are a very callow side in terms of leadership. Hartley took a heavy knock just before halftime. I think he shouldn't have come back, but he was the only leader they had. And I think this was a victory for leadership more than anything else.
It was like a Rolls Royce in the second half when they changed gear, went into overdrive. It started to flow, and once again you saw Premiership not being able to live with it.
Well, there's a few things you're going to look at in this regard, Tom. You know, first of all, I think that in the second half I picked it up pretty quickly that I thought Northampton looked tired. You know, they'd had a long season, they had a physical match last week against Leinster. Yeah, but they had a physical match, one day less. But once Leinster, and they talked about it, Sean O'Brien talked about, once Leinster could hold on to the ball, because they created three or four chances in that first half to actually get in behind them. One, Brian O'Driscoll just lost the ball. Another occasion, Strauss was through. They missed a couple of opportunities. I think they were right. Once they held on to the ball, once they dictated the way that they could play, then Northampton didn't have an answer. And I mean, had that game got another 10 or 15 minutes, it could have been a 30 or 40 point margin. I mean, it was so one way in the second half for Leinster.
Let's start looking at the tries, George. Let's start in this first half. And Brian O'Driscoll falling off a lot of tackles here. We have never seen that before.
No, I don't think Brian O'Driscoll was fit. I don't think he had a game by his immeasurable standards, Greg. But the defending in the first half was very, very poor in the midfield, around the edges of the ruck. And it's a very, very simple try to give away.
Yeah, the second one. They were finding gaps on Leinster. Leinster were just a bit jittery, just seemed to be a bit nervous, and they couldn't get the game together. I mean, this was a pretty simple, just numbers tape. But to say Brian O'Driscoll will be annoyed at that, he fell off the tackle, and this was just before half time.
And this was vital, Popey. Yeah. I mean, this really, you would have said at that point, this is the match-defining moment. When Hartley scores, you have to think here, Northampton can't lose the match.
And then, you know, the one thing the Northampton coach would have said, look, keep Leinster out for at least 15 minutes in the second half. Leinster come out in the first few minutes of the second half and Sexton is over. Within three, four, 5 minutes
Here's
of the second
crucial
half.
One, though, because he slipped absolutely cynically, takes the open side flanker out and Pratt misses it. And this was crucial because there should have been a yellow card to Leinster at this point.
Well, he just runs into him.
Well, there should have been a yellow card against Leinster at that point, and then Hines does well here.
But for all that and all that, to come back from there, Brent, have we ever seen a game like it?
No, and that's what I'm saying. I mean, it was a hard one to watch because George is right. At 22 points or 16 points margin at half-time, you thought Leinster are going to struggle here. And then it was so comfortable in the second half. As I said, the game was effectively over as a contest, I felt, 10, 15 minutes before the end of the game.
The problem for anybody watching this match, like you and I, Brent, is how do you explain a Leinster scrummage and a Leinster front row who are humiliated. I mean,
in the first half.
Yeah, that's the only expression you can use. How can you explain they are humiliated? Probably the worst performance by an Irish front row in a decade. Yeah. And then in the second half, now you can only say at that point that Northampton stopped.
Let's just look at these scrums, because that's what you were talking about.
Well, in the first half. I mean, not only would Leinster have been worried, Declan Kidney watching would have been severely worried going to the World Cup with the front row. Such was the decimation. To the extent they were getting tight heads.
These are the mistakes all over the place.
I mean, you can see Leinster that they were getting the holes. They were making the breakthroughs. It was just uncharacteristic. Here's a typical example here. Great opportunity there to possibly score, get into a great field position, knocks the ball on. Forward passes, just uncharacteristic for Leinster, a bit jittery at the start. But we're going to go back to the scrums again. I think the scrums were the talking point of the game, because George is right. You know, you're in a situation where Leinster, seven men Northampton were down to, and still pushing Leinster off the ball. You can't tell me what is ever said at half-time can be tactical enough to change the whole scrum. I thought Northampton, something just imploded for them in the second half.
This is an embarrassment by Leinster, and this is Sean O'Brien, the tight end, who's had an absolutely wonderful season, hasn't bent the knee to any loose end so
Mike Ross,
far.
Yeah.
Mike Ross, I mean, and Mike Ross is destroyed with Keane. But look at this here, the tight end absolutely annihilates him. Now here's the second half, Brent. How do you explain that?
Second half, not only do Leinster get a platform, but Leinster start to dominate to such an extent that now it's Damien Heslop has the armchair ride. And conversely, what starts to happen is Heslop comes into the game more, Sean O'Brien becomes unstoppable, Keane Healy becomes unstoppable, and suddenly, going forward, Leinster are a whole
different. Is that about sitting in
position.
A dressing room and saying we're 14 points ahead, we've won this match?
From Northampton's point of view,
Well,
it was foolish if they did, because any coach worth his salt will say, hold on, Leinster are going to have to come and play this. They're going to have to chase us. We'll hold out for 15 minutes and put the pressure on. But
it's leadership, it's leadership. I think Hartley was gone mentally at this point. Might even be concussed.
But the scrums can't be leadership.
The scrum was awful. He bit somebody's finger.
I thought they just looked dead on their feet. Yeah. You see, they had given everything in the first half.
Yeah.
They looked dead on their feet in the second half. Suddenly Tongariro couldn't scrum, couldn't have the energy, and Leinster with a fitter, better prepared side.
Brian O'Driscoll looked just about, 60% fit?
Yeah,
there is this moment when a year ago he'd been gone under the posts.
Well, you'd always pick Brian O'Driscoll even at 60%.
6%.
Yeah, but I mean, there's a moment here where the old O'Driscoll, I think, would have cantered home. And the fact that not only is he tackled, but he loses the ball in the tackle, is so uncharacteristic that you know he's probably hurting for the entire 80 minutes. But his value to the side is enormous. And this is where I think, like, you had Sexton, you had O'Driscoll, you had Cullen,
We talked all week, and all the media talked, and rightly so, about how Northampton would handle the pressure. They got into a situation where any other team in the European Cup would have said, hold on, we're 16 points clear here now, keep the rudder straight, we can win this.
Let's summarise it. We've sat in these chairs now for a long time looking at great Irish performances.
Too long.
Maybe that is the best Irish side we've ever turned out, that Leinster side.
Well, it's certainly...
Internationals or provinces?
Well, you'd have to look at the route they took, Tom. You know, other groups have come through. This was a group of death. They got over there. They beat Toulouse. They beat Leicester. They beat Clermont. You name all the quality sides.
They beat
them on the way. It's not as if they turned over a few easy sides, got in there and won, and they were emphatic. I mean, the second half, to come back from being that far down to win comfortably shows you how good they are.
And we were huffing and puffing about Schmidt at the start of the season. We got to bend the knee. Courtesy to him.
I thought Schmidt's performance as coach to Leinster this year, after a very poor start, in which I really, really was concerned, he has been extraordinary. He may well now be, I think he is,
the best coach that Leinster have
ever had in a professional era.
We're going to a break to look to the future, but briefly, the new faces have appeared. Sean O'Brien, from the growing cocks in County Carlow.
Sean O'Brien, Mike Ross, the list goes on. I mean, Sean O'Brien has been magnificent since McFadden came on, a bit unlucky. The list goes
what a
on
generation.
And on. And I mean, McLaughlin. It's exciting news for Irish rugby. They're going out to a World Cup now in the Irish colours, so all to play for.
Well, congratulations to Leinster. Congratulations to Connacht into the Heineken. As I said, Irish sides won 4 of the last 6. It's truly a golden generation and golden times. Let's hope it continues. After the break, we're going to look forward to 2013. I can see the future.
Each ticket covers all 17 home matches. Offer only available until June 1st. For more info or to buy tickets now, check out leinsterrugby.ie/season tickets.
Hello, mate. Weeds, they really are relentless little blighters. If you don't kill the leaves and the roots, some keep coming back. Resolver 24H does both, giving you visible results in 24 hours. And no more roots means no more weed. Resolver your weed problem with Resolver 24H.
Business is a community. When we work together, it works better for everyone. That's why at Bank of Ireland, we developed National Enterprise Week, a unique opportunity to showcase your business and to meet Ireland's leading entrepreneurs, to network and share ideas, all in your local branch. National Enterprise Week, supporting business in your community from May 20th to 27th. Be part of it.
Welcome to the Steakhouse Angus. Flame grilled Aberdeen Angus beef, applewood smoked bacon, barbecue sauce, cheese and crispy onions. Only at Burger King.
Saying goodbye is never easy. Say goodbye. Don't miss the season finale of Desperate Housewives. See it first, Tuesday at 9.55 on RTE2.
Welcome back. We just thought we might look down the road tonight to 2014, in fact, 3 years down the road. And the panel have been looking at some of the new names that might appear. A Leinster side that you've picked, looking at the academy, looking at the guys. Yeah. Take us through the names.
Well, it's very hard, isn't it? I mean, because we're just speculating, obviously. But, you know, Healy's still there. He's probably going to have about 100 caps for him. Strauss, I know Cronin is coming, but we'll stick with it. The only talking point, I suppose, McLaughlin, we've gone for a second row because there's so many young back rowers. I've got Dominic Ryan in there at seven. Young Gilsonen, who was a successful, you know, great player for Congos. He could come through in a couple of years, possibly not as a seven.
Luke McGrath, number nine.
Yeah, number McGrath, the Irish school. Again, only a young player. And then look at that back line. Still a lot of experience there, even in 3 or 4 years' time. Sexton, O'Malley, Conway, Rob Carney, back McFadden. Still a lot of experience there. I mean, still a good-looking side.
Still another generation to come. The golden generation continues.
You'd like some other players, Ruddock's there. There's other options for them. And there's other guys to come through. This is just, say, you know, who's still around. Under 30 was the
George, we'll cross to Shannon. You look down Munster way. Not as many to select, I think, for
a number of reasons. Leinster are now dominant at underage and schools rugby. So Munster, by definition, less schools, less clubs are likely to struggle. The big hopes are Archer at tight end, Nagel, who was man the match against Australia. Coughlin must mature into a leader at eight. Murray, a good scrum half. Keatley from Connacht must nail it down. Hannan's an interesting fella. Captain of the under-20s. Earls will still be there with Zeebo.
Zeebo's huge power, hasn't he?
Yes, but hasn't delivered as yet. Neither Felix Jones. This future Munster team wouldn't beat Popey's future Leinster.
Well, I'd have to disagree on one thing. I think Felix Jones has delivered.
And just
in a word,
should they be buying overseas players or should they be developing this talent, Brad?
Well, overseas players have worked. Look at Nasiwa. You know,
well,
if you get a good
have.
One. No, exactly. If you look at Dougie Howland, if you get a good overseas player, they can bring experience, they can bring that leadership into it. If you get a bad one, okay, we know what happens. Munster must buy.
Their only way out is to buy. Leinster could conceivably exist on the conveyor belt from the academy. Munster can't.
Now, it's World Cup year. That's a big result today for Declan Kidden. He'll fly home from Cardiff, a very happy man tonight.
He'll want questions answered like us about the scrum. Yeah. He won't be happy with the first half, and he'll start saying, why did that happen? He'll be happy with the second half because, you know, there was a few positions he'd worry about. But other than that, yes, I mean, the performance, we'd have to say, you know, Shane Jennings coming on, we didn't mention halftime, made a huge difference in the way that Leinster played. Because once Leinster played the width game, the space game, the loose game, Jennings was there to the ball, and that allowed them to play that way.
But, I think the worry is that Italy will look at the scrum and say this could work for us in Dunedin. Again, the health of Brian O'Driscoll is absolutely...
He shouldn't play next week, should he?
Oh, well, he will play because he's another Vaughan who won a double.
He shouldn't have played last week.
Yeah. But he needs a rest after. He'll get a rest.
Is there a case now for playing every second game? Given
well, for Brian, I think there's a case of after if they win the Magnus League and that's enough against Munster, then he needs a rest. And I wouldn't risk him in the. I'd risk him only in maybe one of those international games leading to the World Cup, because you're right. World Cup is crucial that Brian.
Looking back, George, what's emerged this season, really, Johnny Sexton is looking head and shoulders. His performance today, he scored everything but 5 points. Was magnificent, wasn't it?
I thought,
I don't have to say it because people advise to watch a rugby match. He was a giant today, but I was more impressed by the fact there's a moment in the first half where Leinster are in disarray, Northampton have scored another try, and strangely enough, it's not Cullen, it's not O'Driscoll, it's Sexton.
He's given out the mistake.
Well, Brian O'Driscoll even admitted at half time it was Johnny Sexton, and he talked about what he said was the fact that Liverpool come back, other great teams have come back. This is now a young man that's taking, as George said, the leadership role, and I mean, he was fantastic today, as he's been all
These
season.
These Kerry men born in Dublin.
Lest we get carried away. I would have thought before the game we were worried about Sexton's kicking game, and in the first half the Leinster kicking game was very
poor. Couldn't let him get away.
What I'm saying is very important. It's very important.
We'll let him away with it today.
Why they played badly in the first half? We have to try and analyse those reasons.
But quickly, I mean, just
go for another day. I got to leave you guys now. Looking ahead, the Guineas Racing Festival continues at the Curragh tomorrow. And we've got full live coverage online.
Back Johnny Sexton on
Radio
3:30.
Two very big dates for your rugby diary. Next Saturday, 4:30, RT2. Full live coverage of the Magnus League final, Munster and Leinster from Thomond Park. There won't be a dry eye on the house. And look a little further, of course, we've mentioned it. Put on the alarm clock, get the breakfast cooking, and join us 7 o'clock, Sunday, September 11, Ireland against the USA. In Rugby World Cup 2011, the match live and in full from New Zealand, from New Plymouth rather, on southwest coast of New Zealand. Thank you very much. Thank you, Brent. Thank you, George. Our congratulations to Leinster. I think we can all celebrate goodbye.